why get into cable? It was basically that I was a young entrepreneur looking for opportunities. And there was a consultant in the area who was trying to sign up people to apply for cable license. And I thought, well, that might be interesting. Of course, didn't know what I was doing, but in 1968, when I built a frozen food plant, I didn't know what I was doing either.
My sort of earliest memory was really that process of the maturing of the business, from going from just a handful of small little ones to an actual, you know, good-sized, reasonable telecom operation. When I started, we had, I think, less than 100 employees, and I knew them all. And now we're, I don't know, what, 1,400, 1,500?
And I think to move from trying to do it all myself to having just a tremendous, capable team of people who are all so much more capable than I am and talented and dedicated is really something to be proud of.
We didn't know what we couldn't do. We just thought, what a great opportunity. Let's just figure it out. We didn't let a lot of the past paradigms and past issues drive our future decisions. We just said, well, we're just gonna try to figure it out. We grew up in rural Canada. We're gonna help provide for rural Canada.
Over the years, we've had so many dedicated people that have worked hard and have committed their time night and day to servicing the customers and developing the systems. So it's obviously the credit belongs to all those people who have put in so many hours.
If there's no way one person or even a handful of people could accomplish this. It had to be by building such a great team, and that's always amazed me how we were always able to accomplish that. And I always felt, get the best people around us.
And we have lots of people saying, what are you going to do in the next 5 years? And I've always said, well, I really don't know, but let's look back five and see what we've done. And it's always amazing what we've done in the last five. So will it be amazing in the next five? I hope so.